Hey everyone, I'm Mike and welcome to the Lion's Lounge, where today I'm going to be making some cocktails picked by you. A few weeks back, I made a post on my various socials asking what cocktails you'd like me to make for you. This is something I've been toying with doing for a little bit because I really like the concept of making a cocktail from scratch based on user suggestions. So I picked four suggestions and I'm gonna be kind of workshopping them as I go along. This is gonna be a little bit different than my usual videos where I kind of have a recipe prepared. It's a little bit more ad hoc. In certain cases, I have a rough idea of what I'm gonna make, but in others, I'm kind of just winging it. So without further ado, let's get started. So my first cocktail request was for a spicy passion fruit margarita. Spicy margaritas aren't that unheard of. It's basically just jalapeno mixed with lime juice and some tequila, which I'm gonna do here, but there's also that passion fruit piece that is a little bit different. And what's funny is I really wanted to try this passion fruit liqueur called Chinola. Initially, I couldn't really find it, so I opted for something a little bit cheaper, which is this Passoia. It was definitely cheaper than this, and when I tasted it, it tastes like cough medicine. It's not good at all. Do not recommend this. The Chinola, on the other hand, tastes kind of like passion fruit juice with a little bit of booze in it. Highly recommend this over this. This is garbage. This is great. So with that in mind, this is going to be a shaken drink. And to start, I'm gonna take a jalapeno pepper and just cut a couple slices that I'm gonna add into my shaker. So because I don't really like my margaritas super spicy, I'm just gonna do just like three or four slices. And then next I'm going to add an ounce or 30 milliliters of fresh lime juice. For this, do not discard the lime husk. You're gonna need that later. And then I'm just gonna add a quarter ounce of agave nectar right into the shaker. Okay, with all that added, gently muddle the pepper to incorporate it into the rest of the drink. It's really just gonna release those juices, give it a little bit more of a kick. What you wanna do here is just press it. Don't turn it, just give it a good press. And then I'm gonna add 2 ounces or 60 milliliters of a Blanco tequila. This part, I pretty much am just following a normal spicy margarita spec. Okay, so it's at this point when I workshop my cocktails, I'll usually give it a stir to incorporate the ingredients and then give it a quick taste, see how my ratios are, especially because I'm gonna add the Chinola next. I want to see how this is, see exactly how much Chinola I think I need to add. It's pretty good so far. Okay, this is a little bit spicy. Passion fruit can be a little bit of a strong flavor. So I'm gonna start by adding just a quarter ounce or 7.5 milliliters. And then give it a quick stir, give it a taste, see how it is. Maybe I'll add more. Yep, I'm gonna bump this up to a full 1/2 ounce. What I'm trying to do here is not have the passion fruit be the sole flavor going on here. I want that spice to come in and I want the notes of the tequila as well. What you're looking for really is sort of a harmony between all the ingredients. You don't want one ingredient overpowering the rest, you kind of want a balance. Okay, so now I'm gonna add some ice to my shaker and give it a shake for about 12 to 14 seconds. Next, I'm gonna take a double old fashioned glass and crack some ice into the glass. Then I'm gonna double strain into the glass. So, I forgot to do the rimming. 1 second. Okay, take a plate and add some chili powder to the plate. Now, I'm gonna grab one of my lime husks and rim about 1/2 the glass. And what you're trying to do here is not get the chili powder into the glass. You're just trying to get it gently on the outside. Now I'm gonna pour back into the glass. And lastly, I'm going to garnish this with a couple slices of the jalapeno pepper. And there you have a spicy passion fruit margarita. Cheers. That's very good. The passion fruit is there. It's not overpowering. You initially get the passion fruit and then it gives way to the agave notes of the tequila. And then that spice comes in at the very end and it is spicy. It's a little sweet, not too sweet. A little tart, not too tart. It's good. Let me see how it is with the chili powder garnish. Whew. Yeah, that adds a little bit of a kick, but it's good. This is very good, in fact. I might have to make more of these later. Okay, so my next request was for a savory cocktail with vodka. So this one was pretty interesting. Doing a little bit of research, I found a interesting recipe I wanted to give it a try, and it is a basil martini. Funny thing, it's actually really hard to find basil right now. I went to multiple grocery stores, no fresh basil. So I had to get some chopped fresh basil. I also wanted to garnish it with basil, but again, no basil. So I'm gonna use mint instead, but if you can find fresh basil, try that instead. So this one's gonna be another shaken drink, and I'm gonna start with maybe like a bar spoon of this basil. It is chopped, so might need less. Start with a bar spoon. Basil is pretty strong, so I don't want this to just taste like basil. I'm also gonna add lime juice in this to incorporate a little bit of tartness. So speaking of the lime juice, let's do an ounce or 30 milliliters of that. Yeah, that's definitely strong basil, but I think if I want to tone it down a little bit, I'll add, let me start with a quarter of simple syrup and see if I need to add more. That's not bad. So this was actually just a bit over a quarter. It's closer to a third, but so far it's not terrible. And the vodka, let's do 2 ounces of vodka. Let's give this a stir, see if there's anything else we think we need. Okay, that might be the winner. Okay, so I'm gonna add some ice to my shaker and give it a shake for about 12 to 14 seconds. And because there's little basil chunks in there, I definitely need to double strain this. And I'm gonna serve this up, which means no ice, into a Nick and Nora glass. Even after double straining it, there's still tiny little chunks of basil, but that's fine. All right, and there we have a basil martini. Cheers. You know, not terrible. It definitely has basil in it. I'm glad I didn't go over a bar spoon because this is kind of just enough. The vodka is there, but it's kind of taking it back into that basil. A little bit tart from the lime juice, which is nice. It's kind of very one note. It doesn't really have a lot going on. It's essentially just basil and, you know, lime, so a little bit tart. Not really boozy, honestly, in at least in terms of how it tastes. Yeah, I mean, it's not bad. It's pretty good. It's not my favorite drink I've ever made, but it's pretty good. Okay, so next I was asked to make a cocktail with root beer. There's already a really good cocktail incorporating root beer, which is called a Naughty Dog. It's basically just a Demerara Rum, Kahlua, root beer, and then some heavy cream on top. And I wanted to go with that template, but jazz it up just a little bit. So this is pretty easy to make, wherein you just make it right in the glass, and you're gonna start with your Demerara Rum, which I'm using Eldorado 5-Year. And to this, you're gonna add 1.5 ounces or 45 milliliters. Next, I'm gonna add Plantation OFTD, which is an overproof rum. It's 69%. So I'm not gonna add a lot of this. It's only gonna be 1/2 ounce. So this is essentially a split rum-based cocktail. What's cool about this rum is it is blended. It's from Guyana, Barbados, and Jamaica. So it is gonna have some Jamaican funky notes in it, which if you don't know what that means, it means essentially an overripe banana taste. And then instead of the Kahlua, I'm gonna go with this Mr. Black, which is rested in rum barrels. Mr. Black is a coffee liqueur. It's very good. I've done several videos incorporating it. This one is amazing. It tastes great, and you get a little bit of that hint of the rum. So for this, I'm gonna add 1 ounce or 30 milliliters. All right, let's give this a quick stir and incorporate the ingredients, and then we'll give it a quick taste and see how it is. It's pretty good. Okay, now I'm gonna add a big ice cube into my glass. And then I'm gonna give it a stir for about 30 seconds. Then I'm gonna top this up with some root beer. And then I'm gonna float some heavy cream over top. And then I'm gonna garnish it with some fresh nutmeg. And there you have the extra Naughty Dog. Cheers. I already like rich drinks that have, you know, cream, nutmeg. Usually we'll have rum or whiskey. You get kind of all the parts here. And surprisingly, the Plantation OFTD is not overpowering. Initially, when you mix the rums and the coffee liqueur, it's just alcohol hits you right in the face. It is very subdued after you add some ice, after you add the root beer and then the heavy cream. It's not that it isn't there, it's there, but it's kind of mellowed a little bit. Very good. Highly recommend this. If you haven't made a Naughty Dog before, try it out. Try adding this if you can. I know it is a little bit difficult to find right now, but it's worth it. Trust me. Okay, onto our final cocktail, and this one's pretty straightforward. It's a cocktail containing coffee and caramel, which is basically just a coffee martini with caramel in it, but I want to make it a little bit more interesting. So for this, rather than using vodka, which is a pretty common ingredient in a coffee or espresso martini, I'm gonna use a bourbon. What I'm hoping here is that the bourbon helps accentuate some of the other flavors. You have sort of a little bit more character than just, you know, coffee and caramel. And so for this, I'm gonna start with an ounce and a half or 45 milliliters and see where I go from there. Next, I'm going to use coffee liqueur. And in this case, just standard Mr. Black. And I'm gonna use 2 ounces of this. Coffee and bourbon go great together. It's usually how I make my espresso martinis. I don't use vodka. I use rye whiskey or bourbon. Great. Okay, next, I'm going to use my caramel syrup. Don't want to make it too sweet, but I do want to taste the caramel. So I'm going to try a half. That might be too much, but we'll see. Nope, that is just perfect. Okay, and then let's try adding some bitters. I'm gonna start with Angostura, and let's do, what is this? Cocoa bitters too. Let's do a dash of that. That way you have a nice little bourbon, coffee, caramel, chocolate note. That's looking pretty good. Now I'm gonna add some ice and give it a shake for about 12 to 14 seconds. I'm going to double strain this into a coupe. And then I'm gonna give it a garnish with an orange peel just to have a little bit more. I've already got a lot going on here. I've got bourbon, I've got coffee. Orange goes perfectly with coffee. And there you have a caramel espresso martini. Cheers. That is pretty good. I can't really say that the caramel is front and center. It's there, it's in the back end. Coffee and the bourbon are the most prevalent flavors. You do get some spice notes from the Angostura bitters. The chocolate bitters are kind of there, but it's very subtle. It is definitely sweet though. I don't think I would add any more caramel syrup because I think it would make it too sweet. It's more just you taste coffee and bourbon, and then that sweetness comes in towards the tail end. I'm also gonna add that the orange is definitely there. Once you have that spritz on there, you get the smell of it immediately. Once you take the first sip, you get the orange, gives way to the bourbon and the coffee, and then you get the sweetness from the caramel. I'm trying to think of a way I would possibly tweak this, maybe remove the bitters so that the caramel is a little bit more, you know, in your face, but I also like it the way it is. I like caramel, I like sweetness, but I don't want just caramel. I like a complex cocktail with a lot going on. So there you have it, 4 cocktails that you requested. I always enjoy making cocktails based on suggestions, so if you want to see me do a video like this again, let me know in the comments below. As well as if you have any recipes you'd like me to make too. And if I don't make it in a video, I may make it offline. Which is why you should also check me out on Twitter at Mr. Spacelion or Instagram at Mr.Spacelion. Well, my friends, thank you so much for watching. I've been your bartender, Mike, and I hope to see you next time.